Hello everybody, I am Tashi Mori, and in this video here, I will teach you how to make the origami Western Dragon by Shuki Kato. But before we start making this origami, let me explain you some things. Well, this origami here is a super complex one. It's even more complex than the origami Ancient Dragon or the Phoenix or my origami Scorpion. Well, among all the videos I have, this will be the most difficult one. So you must be prepared, you must be really experienced with the origami. And you should also follow the diagram at the same time, so it's going to be easier for you to understand some steps if you follow the diagram and the video at the same time. And you should use a good paper. This one here I use it Taiyuryu paper with CMC glue and painted with acrylic paint, and this one has 50 centimeters. So you should use a paper with at least 50 centimeters, that's about 20 inches. So that's it, let's start. So to make this origami, you're going to use 1 square sheet of paper. It's recommended to use a paper with at least 50 centimeters, that's about 20 inches. And well, here I'm going to use a small paper to make it easier to teach. And as this origami here is a super complex one, you should use the diagram at the same time to see some references. So let's start. First of all, fold here the diagonal. I'm going to teach a little bit fast here in the easy parts, because well, as this origami here is a really complex one, I'm going to spend more time in the complex parts. And well, now fold here in half again, but just mark here this part, okay. And unfold. Now fold here this point up to this point here, but again we are just going to pinch here to make mark here on this side. Now you're going to fold this point up to this mark here. Okay, now we have this mark, we are going to fold along this line here, making at this point go up to this last mark we just made here, right? Okay, now unfold, and you're going to make a fold along this line here, making, so just see here the reference, okay, we just made here a small square, this side here, the paper. Now you're going to fold here, well, first turn the model over and fold here, making the side of the paper go up to the middle line. This. Now turn the model over again and make a fold here along, as you can see here, you have this line here and this line here. You're going to make a fold in a line that that's exactly this point here. Okay. Now you're going to make a fold along a line here parallel with this one here, and passing on this point here. Okay. Well, to make it easier, you can use the reference here, the back side of the paper. You have this line, so it gets easier if you use this reference. It's a little bit hard to see. Well, as you can see, it's aligned here. Okay, now unfold and do the same thing here.
Let me see. Now you have to make a fold exactly in the middle here of these two lines. So just make a fold here. Oh, it's easier if you fold it to this side first and make this line go up to the middle line. Okay, so we just made here these two lines and do the same thing here. Okay, now this part here, this top part here, you're going to fold in six parts. Well, it's just like this. You have to fold here in half. First of all, you fold it, making this point here go up to this point here. Okay, now you're going to fold each part here in three. And unfortunately, you don't have any reference to do this. So you just, okay, so you have to make it by trying sometimes until you get it right. Now it's about this much. Okay. Okay, so I just divided it in six parts, right? Now you have to unfold here this layer and make a fold along this line here. This line here from this point to this point here. Just like this, making this point here go up to this one. Okay. Now unfold here, and you're going to make a fold along this line here. Just make a mark here to make it easier to see. You have these two lines, right? You have to make a fold exactly in this direction here, passing along this point here. Okay. So this direction here. Okay. So these first steps here, it's easier if you follow the diagram, okay? So now you have to make another fold parallel with this one here, passing along this point here. So make this fold go up to this line here. Okay, so up to this line here. this. Now you have to make a fold. Okay, you have this line and this line. Make a fold along this line here. Parallel with this one here, passing through this point here. So, make a fold from this point up to the side of the paper. Okay, and do the same thing here. So you have this line and this line. Let's make a fold here. Right, now you have to make a fold from, you have this line and this line, also this line and this line, right? You have to make a fold from this point to this point here. Okay, now make a fold from this point to this point here, okay, and also here. Like this. Now turn the model over and you're going to make a fold along this line here, okay? Making the side of the paper go up to this line here. And do the same thing here, making the side of the paper go up to this line here. So this. Okay, do the same thing here. Okay, now you have to make a fold along this diagonal here. A diagonal, okay, this one here. You have to make a fold from this point here up to this point here. Okay, and fold up to the end of the paper. So just made this fold here. Okay, and do the same thing here. So, and okay, so we have something like this, right? Okay, now we have to make a fold like this. Fold here, the side of the paper, up to this line here. Okay, like this. And fold up to this line here. Let me show you. We just made a fold from this point here up to this line here. Okay. I know it's a little bit hard to see the references, but yeah. Try to follow the diagram, okay, in these parts. Now we have to make a fold from this point here up to this point here. So do the same thing here. Let me show you again. Fold here, right? And fold from this point to this point here. That's it. Right. Now it's going to get a little bit hard now. Well, first you have to fold here and here on this first line here and make a rabbit ear fold here in the end. So just squish in the middle like this. Okay? Now make a fold from this point here up to this point here. So basically you have to fold making this point go up to this line, covering all the white parts. Like this. Okay, now turn the model over and we have to make these folds here. You make a belly fold along this line here. This one here. And this one here at the same time. So it's like this. Here. Here. Right? So now you just pull here this layer downwards and the back layer is going to cover here the white part. Okay, like this. Do the same thing here. Like this. Now you have to divide here this part in three. Okay, you have this line, right? I'll just fold a little bit better. So you have this line, you're going to divide this line in three, and also you're going to divide here this line in three. Okay, but only up to this line here. So basically you're going to make a line along this one and this one. And do the same thing here. So something like this. You have to divide here. Okay, the model is going to look like this, divided here into three parts, here and here. Now you're going to unfold everything. And spread here the paper a little bit. Now fold here everything in half and fold here along the second line down like this and do the same thing here to the other side. fold along the second line. This part I can see that I didn't fold it precisely. Well, anyway, now you have to fold here along this line, right? Unfold and you're going to make a reverse fold along this line here. Here, you're going to do the same thing, fold here, and make a reverse fold. So, the rim is going to look like this. Now you're going to fold here this flap to the left and you're going to divide here this part here in six parts again. So make a line here and fold each line in three parts. Now you have to align here, just a little bit, this line with this one, okay? You have six lines in this direction and six lines in this direction. Okay, so the model should look like this, okay? You have these lines. Now, this part here is going to be a little bit confusing, so let me zoom in. And, well, this part here, I really recommend you choose the diagram because there are too many lines and there's just no other way to explain it. You just have to fold like this, okay? Okay, so you just have to make all these folds here. So pay close attention to the references or use the diagram here to make it easier for you to see the folds. But you basically you have to make all these folds. There's no way for me to explain it with more details. You just have to keep looking at the references and make these folds. So after you make these folds here, you're going to make some more folds like this, okay? Okay, so just make this fold, so it's like this and this, right? And do the same thing here, do the same thing to this side here. Okay, so after you make all the folds, it's going to look like this. Well, I know it's really confusing, okay, but if you practice here, you will see that there is a pattern here. It's not really so hard to understand all these folds, because this side and this side here is symmetrical along with this line here, okay? So here and here are symmetrical. Well, this may help you a little bit. Now you have to make a sequence here of sink folds, reverse folds, I'm sorry, reverse folds along these lines here, these parallel lines here. So just open here this top part a little bit reverse along the first one. Now reverse here along the second line. Okay, and keep doing this along all these six lines. Okay, so the model is going to look like this. Okay, now you have to open here this part. Okay, open this flap, and you're going to make a fold here like the tsuru base here. So you have to make, let me just show you, have this triangle here, right? You're going to make a valley fold along this line and two mountain folds, and at the same time you're going to squash here, to press here the sides of the model, and the model is going to look like this. Okay, now you have to fold here this side, making this side here of the paper go up to this line here. Okay, and reverse along the middle line, along this line here. Right, now unfold and make two sink folds here. Okay, it's a little bit hard to make it. And it's going to look like this. Now you have to fold here this flap to the other side. And for it, you have to make a small fold here on this tip. Just like this. Okay. You're going to make a squash fold here. So unfold, you're going to open here this layer, press the middle, okay, and fold it back. Now you're going to fold this layer, and you're going to make another squash fold here. So first of all, make a fold making this line here go up to this line here. Okay, so just like this. Now unfold, and you're going to make an open a squash fold here. So it's like this, it's like an open sink. Okay, make an open sink here. Okay, just like this. But as you can see, in this part here, you're going to make a triangle. You hit this triangle and press here the middle. Okay, I think it was a little bit confusing, you know. But let me just show you again, so make it more clear. So we just made this fold like this, right? Making this line go up to this line. Now we just pulled here this flap and press here the middle, making this triangle, okay, along this fold we just made. Then you press here the middle of the triangle and squash the sides, and the fold is going to look like this. Now you're going to open here this middle layer, okay, like this, and fold it along this middle line, like this, okay? So the model is going to look like this now. So now you have to keep folding here. You have these folds here, right? You have to make it go to this direction here, making a V here. So basically you're going to make another sink folds along this layer. So after you make this fold, the model is going to lie flat again. And again, this origami here is really complex, so you should make every fold really carefully. I'm not making it carefully here, because I need to make it a little bit faster, okay? But if you do not fold carefully, the result is not going to be nice, and there's no point in making the whole origami and it not going to not look nice in the end. Okay, so as you can see, the model is going to lie flat. Now you have to turn here all these flaps to the left and turn the model over. That's better. And do the same thing here. So just show you again a little bit faster now. Open here this layer, okay, making a fold like in the third base, okay. Fold this layer here up to this line, fold to the other direction along the middle line, make two open sink folds, fold here this small tip here, open this layer and squash the middle, fold it back. Now fold this flap, fold along this line here, making this line go up to this line, and pull here this layer, open it, making this triangle here in the middle, squash the sides, press here in the middle. Now open this front layer, fold it back along the middle line, and press here the sides. Now you're going to make a sequence of sink folds.
that's it. The model is going to look like this, and finally it's going to lie flat. Now fold here this layers here downwards, okay? On both sides, I'm going to fold it down. Oops, like this. Right? Now we are going to make this part here. First of all, you're going to make a fold here, spreading both layers like this, okay? So the model is going to look like this. Now you're going to make a reverse fold along this line here and this line here. Okay, inside reverse these two layers. Okay, the model is going to look like this. Now, down here, two layers to the right. One, two. Okay, now we are going to make a fold like this. Open here this top layer, okay, spread these two top layers. And we are going to pull here along the middle line, okay? So pull here this middle line, right? And fold along the third line here. So it is going to look like this for now. Okay? And the sides here, you're going to do the following. You have to pull here the middle line and fold here along the third line. And as you can see, we're going to make two folds here, like a V here, making a V here, right? So the problem with this fold here is that you must make all the folds at the same time, okay? So the other side, you're going to make the same thing. And you'll only be able to make this fold if you make both sides at the same time. So it's going to look something like this for now. So the sides here are going to look like this. You have to open here. The model is going to look like this. I know it's confusing. Okay. So you just have to squash here in the middle. Now you're going to pull here this layer upwards, but at the same time you do this, you're going to make a valley fold along this line and this line here. So it's going to look like this. Okay? Okay, so from this point on, I'm going to use another paper to make it easier to see it and the details. I'm going to use a bigger paper. Okay, now this part here is going to be a little bit difficult to make, okay? You have to pull here this layer and you're going to fold here these lines. I don't know if you can see it, but well, there are some lines making a V shape here. Okay, so you must reverse all these folds. So first, you should reverse this layer, this line here, the outer line. It's going to be like this. Just press here, this part. And you're going to make the origami shape like this. Okay? Now you have to reverse along the second and third line. And the problem here is that the origami is not going to lie flat. So it's going to be
a little bit hard to make this part here. So it's going to look like this, but as you can see, this top part is going to be a little bit messed up. So, well, the model is going to look like this, okay? And do the same thing here. The model is going to look like this. Now fold here this layer down, okay? Just to make it easier to see, you have to reverse now along these lines here. And after you make these reverse folds, these folds are going to lie flat. So it's going to look like this. First, you have to force here a little bit to reverse. Okay. And then after you do this, you have to adjust here this inner part. Making a sequence of V's here inside. Okay. It got a little bit messed up here, but it's okay. Like this. Right? And do the same thing here. So the model is going to look, now the model is going to look like this, and this top part is going to lie flat. Okay, the model is going to look like this now. Now you have to do the following. You have to pull here this layer to the left, and at the same time you have this flap here, you're going to open it and make this line here get straight aligned with this one here. So pull everything you can to the left, and it's going to make this triangle here. And you just finish folding here. And after you do this, fold here to the other side along this middle line here. Okay, now unfold, but do not unfold this part here, just this top layer. Okay, so now you just have to make a closed sink along this first line here. Okay, so it's just like this. You have to push here the model along the first line. Now make a belly fold along the second line. So do the same thing here. So you have to pull here this layer all the way to the right and squash here this middle flap. Fold back along the middle line. Unfold, then make a closed sink along the first crease here. And belly fold along the second crease. like this. Okay, now the top part, we're going to do something a little bit different. You have to make some more bread creases here, so it's going to be like this. First, you're going to fold like this, okay? So, I made a fold along this line. Let me zoom in a little bit. Okay. And make the same thing to this direction here. Okay. Make a fold along this line here. This one here. Okay. Now make a fold along this line here. Okay, going straight to the top of the paper. Okay, like this. And the same thing here. Okay, now you're going to make a reverse fold along this last crease we just made. Like this. Okay, now you're going to turn here this flap to the right, to the left, and do the same thing here. You have to make a reverse fold on this last line here. So the model is going to look like this. So now you have to make a valley fold along this line and a mountain fold along this line here. It's going to be like this. Okay. The model is going to look like this. Now you have to fold here, making this point go up to this point here. Now, on this flap here, you're going to open it. Okay. And make here a petal fold. That's the fold like in the tsuru. Okay, well, it's something like this. You have to pull here this middle layer up. And this fold in the bottom side, just like this. Okay, now pull here both sides and you're going to reverse this flap here. So if you pull here both sides, you can just push this middle flap inside like this. Okay, now you're going to fold here to the right, and at the same time you're going to pull here this middle flap, and it's going to look like this. Now make a valley fold along this line here. Now just open here this layer here. Okay. And you're going to do the same thing along this flap here. So let me just show you again. Okay, so open here, fold this layer up. Now, pull here both sides, push this flap to inside, and fold everything to the left, like this. Now, in this middle flap here, you're going to do almost the same thing. So, first you have to open it and make a petal fold. But, well, we're going to stop here. Now we have to unwrap here this top part. You have two layers together, right? You have to pull here this top layer and fold everything back. Okay, it's going to look like this. Now you have to squash here, open this middle flap like this. Okay, pull here this layer up and fold like the bird base. Okay, so we have something like this now. Fold here this top layer down and fold here all these back off layers upward like this. Now we have to unwrap here both sides. So it's just like this. You have to pull here just the top layer. It's going to look like this. Okay? And you're going to make a rabbit ear fold here. Wrapped your folds something like this. You have to fold everything here back. Okay? And then you're going to make a fold here and squash the middle. Just like this. Do the same thing to this side. So pull here this one layer. Only one layer, okay. Fold this layer back like this and fold top part like this. The model is going to look like this. Now you have to sink here the sides, and well, these parts here are going to be a little bit hard to make, so you just have to make a fold. Just make a fold like this inside, okay? Then, okay, so we have now to make a sink fold along this last fold we just made. A closed sink fold. Okay, like this. Then you're going to fold here. In the first layer, you're going to make a mountain fold. Okay. In the second layer, you're going to make a valley fold. So you're just trying to make these points here get more thin. Okay, so let me just show you again. You just have to make this fold. I don't know if it's necessary to make a sink fold, as both layers are going to get to be trapped. But anyway, it's on the instructions. So let's just try to follow the diagram. Okay, I know it's really hard. This origami here is really hard to make, so you must try to understand what each fold means to make it easier for you to complete the origami. Okay, so the origami is going to look like this now. Okay, now turn the model over, okay? Fold this small flap down. And you're going to fold here and unfold the top edge. Fold and unfold. Fold
unfold like this.
Now, you're going to make an open sink along this line. So, basically, as we did in the other side, we are going to make this top part get more thin. Okay, I hope you could understand this. I don't know if it's exactly an open sink here. There should be an easier way to make it. I think if you just reverse here the top layer three times, we can do the same thing. Well, I don't know. Okay, so as I said, if you reverse fold three times, the result is the same. Okay, just like this. And this remaining flap here, you're going to fold back. So again, if you understand that you're just making this top part get more thin, it gets easier. You don't have to follow all these steps, you just have to think a way to make it get thinner, and it's going to be okay. Okay, this one here got really ugly. Well, the result wasn't really nice here, but something like this. Okay, so we have something like this, right? Fold here, this back of layers down, like this. Now fold here, this layer up to this line, up to this line here. Okay, like this. And at the same time, you're going to fold this line here up to the middle line. Well, it's not exactly up to the middle line, I guess. Oh no, it is. So, just fold like this, narrowing the neck. It's not the neck, it's the tail. So, narrowing the tail. Oh, it's not. Okay, so I wasn't really precise here, I guess. It's going to be like this. Okay. So the model is going to look like this. Now fold here, making this side here of the paper go up to this line here, like this. Okay? Then you pull here this trapped layer and fold here all the way to the end here, this line, and squash here the paper. So everything's going to get aligned here with this line here, right? So again, fold here, pull this layer, make a rabbit here and squash the paper. Now fold these layers up. Now here we are going to make the leg. So first of all, you have to fold here this layer down, this first layer down, okay, and fold here to inside. So you can see the layer. Okay, like this. Now here we are going to make a sequence of reverse folds. It's actually really simple to understand. It's just like this. You have to make a first reverse fold along this line here. Okay, and there will be a triangle here. Now reverse fold again. And we have this. Now you're going to reverse fold one more time. And that's it. You will have one toe. It's going to look like this. Okay? And keep doing this to all the layers here and here. Okay, so you should have something like this, right? Now you have to fold everything in half, like this. And you can already see the shape of the dragon. Okay. Okay, now you have to fold here the wing like this, and at the same time you're going to push here the legs. These parts are going to be the legs, okay? You push down and the model is going to look like this. Okay. Okay, this part here is going to be a little bit confusing again. This one here to make it easier for you to see, and you have to pull here this layer, okay? Pull it, and at the same time you're going to release some layers here from the neck, and okay, it's going to look like this. Okay, so you have something like this, right? After you pull here all the layers, it's going to get a little bit confusing here. Okay, so pay close attention. First of all, you have to fold here this fold, these two folds making a V here. Okay, you're going to make mountain folds along these two lines, and at the same time you're going to fold this layer here in half like this. Okay, now you have to make another V fold here. And this part here is going to be a little bit confusing, but it's like this. You must have this line here and this line here get aligned with this one and this one. Let me just show you. You have to close here and make this line go up to this back line here. Okay? And this front layer are going to have, they're going to be folded the same way. So everything is going to get aligned with this part here. Okay? Now this bottom part here is going to be like this. You have to fold it along this line here. I don't know if you can see it, but you had a lot of lines here and you had parallel lines along this side here. So you have to fold this, okay? And at the same time you're going to fold along the third line here. So the model, as you can see, it's not going to lie flat. This part is going to be folded in half and this part here is folded like a fan. So it's going to look like this. And you just have to fold it. And squash the model here. Again, I know it's really confusing. There's going to be one more step here that's really confusing. Well, but there's just no other way. This origami is a really complex one. And now you're just going to sink here again. You're going to sink here these parallel lines and this one at the same time. So let's just, first of all, let's sink this first line here.
and sync this. This. Now sync here the second line. Okay. It's getting messed here in the middle. This paper here is so thin that gets hard to see the folds. This one got a little bit messed up, but the layers are going to look like this. Okay. So. Okay, now you're going to pull here this layer, the last layer here, down. Like this. Okay. Now you have to pull here, you have this pack of layers. Pull here, these layers, and fold it to the front. Okay. Now they're going to look like this. Okay, now you just have to fold here this part here to the front, like this. And you're going to fold this top layer down like this. Right, now we're going to lock here the top part. Okay, first of all you have to unfold here this inner layer. Okay, you have this layer, sink it here. Right, and it's going to look like this. And fold here along this line here. Okay. Now fold here, making okay. Fold like this, folding the wing in half. Okay, pay attention to this line here. Now fold, making this layer go up to this layer. This line here go up to this line. Okay. Now you just have to mount and fold here along. Okay, fold this layer here to inside. I forgot to fold to inside. Okay. Going to make mount and fold from this point to this point. Here also you're going to fold to inside. Actually you have to make some sync folds here, some reverse folds here to make this layer and this layer get locked. It's not really a strong lock. If you do something like this, you have this pocket here, right? So you can put this layer inside.
and both players are going to stay together.
Well, just a little like this.
So also here, you have to make another fold like this. It's just the same thing. So make one fold, one reverse fold to create a pocket. And insert the other layer in this first one. And as I said, this pocket here is not going to lock the layer very strongly. Okay, that's it. So now you're just going to make here some curves later. Well, this is going to be the wing, so I'm just have to put some effect I'm going to make later. Now you just have to do the same thing to the other wing. So let me just show you a little bit faster now. So first you had to fold everything up and fold the leg down. Right? Pull here these back layers to the front. This. Now you have to fold here this layer up. Pull this layer, open it. Now you have to pull this back of layer down and unfold some layers from the neck. This up to this point here, right? So after you open here these layers, you have to make a reverse fold along this first V here, okay, and align everything with this corner here. Okay, and fold all this layer in half like this. Fold this line here and pull everything. Okay, now you just have to make some reverse folds. Now you have to fold this back layer down. Pull here this back layers in front. Okay, so the wings are going to look like this. Okay, I know it's a little bit hard to make the wings, but well, it's going to look like this in the end. So try to shape it. Well, as I use it, a paper with color on both sides, everything is orange here, red. So if you use a paper with color only on one side, the wings are going to be white. Now let's continue. Now we're going to make the neck. So now in the neck you have, I don't know if you can see here, but you have three folds here shape in a V shape. Okay, here, here, and here. Okay, you have these three folds here. You're going to fold along the last one. Okay, like this. And you're going to make a reverse fold along all these layers. So, just do it. It's going to be a little bit hard to make this. You have to pull everything and make a reverse fold one by one on all these layers. So, let's just do it. Okay, I did reverse everything and it's going to look like this. Okay, now in this part here, you're going to do this. You have to push here the second layer, okay? You have this second layer, you have to reverse fold along the second layer and reverse fold here also the second layer in the bottom like this. Okay, the model is going to look like this. Now fold here the side of the paper. Like this. Now unfold and make an open sink along this fold we just made. Now you have to spread here along this fold here. You have to make a mountain fold along this first line here and a mountain fold along this line here on the back. And basically you're just going to spread here both layers. This. And it's going to look like this. Okay, now the next step here is going to get really confusing. So it's really hard to follow even the diagram. It's really hard to understand the diagram. So try to understand here what this step is about. So first of all, fold your two layers, okay, up like this. Now here we are going to do the following. We must make here. We have okay, these three layers here, right? We want to make two tips, one here and one here. So this part here is going to sink here. And well, let me just show you now. We have something like this, okay? Three layers here. Now, fold here. This layer like this and this back layer here like this. And now you have to pull here this, you have these three layers, right? You have to pull this one and this one here and make a straight fold from this point to this point and also from this point here. Okay, we just made this fold, right? We just made this fold here.
and this one here. Okay, so make here straight fold from this point to this point here. It's just like this. I know it's hard, it's really hard to understand, but well, it will be something like this. Okay, now you just sink here the middle. Now, as you can see, we still don't have two tips here. So, we are going to make a sequence of folds here. Okay, here. Okay, here. And here. Here. So, we are going to narrow these two points here. And well, this step here is going to be really hard. First, you have to squash here the middle a little bit, like this. And make a valley fold here now along this line here. These two lines are going to get aligned with each other. So you have to do this, basically. Okay? And also here. Right. Okay, well, anyway, you have to follow to fold here one layer, two layers, these two layers up now. And here you're going to do the same thing you did in this part here. Okay, so try to understand here the idea, because it's really hard to follow the diagram or even the video. And it's basically this: we had three layers and I made two tips from these three layers here, and I did the same thing here. This part here was a little bit more confusing, but it's basically the same thing. Now you're going to do the same thing here in this layer here, the next layer. And it's let me just remind you, you just have to reverse fold, okay, this middle layer, and do the same thing here in the bottom part, okay. Like this, right? Now you just have to fold here, like this, right? Now open sync here. Right, open sync. Now open squash here the middle. So again we had three layers and it became two tips like this. So do the same thing here to the other side. So basically it's always the same thing. You had three layers and we're going to make two tips. Okay, so after you finish this,
The model is going to look something like this, okay? You have to reverse this layer all the way. And that's it. We're basically dividing here the layers in two. And it's going to look like this. And here, as you can see, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tips. Just like this. Now you have to make here the same thing. No, not the same thing, but you have to make a reverse fold here along all the layers. So again, you have to... Well, this part is going to be easier than before because you have half the amount of layers, right? But anyway, you have to pull here everything. You have to pull everything and reverse layer by layer. Like this. Okay, now I don't know if you can see here, but you have this two lines here, right? Pay attention here, you have one line here and two more lines here. So you're going to take this last line here as a reference and you're going to make a fold like this. You have to fold only on the top layer, okay? Fold this line up to this line here. So like this, okay? Now fold this line we just made up to this line here. And now we are going to make a zigzag fold, okay? So like this, and fold back. Now fold along this line here. Okay, like this. So if you let me unfold here, as you can see, we just made these four lines here, right? Now just unfold everything and make a fold now here. Okay, and unfold. Now open sync this last fold we just made. Open sync. So what we are doing here, it's just we're narrowing even more at these parts here, okay? So if you get the idea, it's really going to get somehow obvious of what the next steps are going to be. Like, okay, so we have here, we just have to sync fold along this point here and keep doing something like this. So, well, but before we do this, let's just continue here with this layer. So you have to spread sync here again. Okay. So it's going to look like this.
I'm trying to make it a little fast here when I'm teaching, but do it slowly, try to be really precise on every fold,
okay?
So now we have to make a fold here. We just think a little bit. Okay, so we just have to make a fold like this. We just spread here these two layers, right? Now you're going to make these two folds here and here. Oh no, sorry. We're going to make a fold here. So basically we're going to make another tip here in this point
behind.
So it's something like this. You just have to press here the sides again and make the back look like this. Okay. On both sides. So. Like this, okay? It's not easy. I know there's a part here. Okay, so now we have to fold here this layer down and do what I said before. Fold here and sink fold here. So it's going to look like this. Now you're going to do the same thing here as we did in this first layer. And well, let me just do it again. So first you have to fold the side here. Okay. And make that zigzag fold. Right, unfold everything like this, fold inside reverse and open sink, not inside reverse. Now squash fold. Okay. And press your two sides. Look a little bit like the Tsuru base here. Okay. Now close it. So we have something like this right now. Okay. And now you're going to reverse here this point here from inside. Okay. So it's going to look like this right now, and be careful here when you reverse, because you have to fold along the references. Okay, so as you can see, we just made one more tip here. Now fold here this point to the right, and here you can see how imprecise I was in my folds. Well, anyway, fold here, now close back everything here up, and fold the first point to the right. Okay. Now you have to fold here just this first point, okay? Make a square shirt, fold it in the middle like this, and at the same time you fold this down, okay? And the second point here, you're also going to squash and fold these layers down. Okay, so it's going to be like the horns. Okay, so we have these tips here are going to be, I don't know if they are horns or whatever. And okay, it's going to look like this. Do the same thing here. So all the steps, I don't know if you remember all the steps, but do the same thing to this side here. Also, I will show you just a little bit faster to remind you of all the steps. Okay, so the model should look like this. And as you can see here, it's getting pretty imprecise, not precise here in these points. So, anyway, let's continue. First fold here, this, okay, everything in half like this. Okay, unfold, I mean. So,
just like this, exactly in the middle.
Now you're going to squash here. I'll open here this part and squash here, but you have to divide here these layers evenly. Okay, so like this, and you squash here.
Now let's see the model in
this position here. First, fold here along this line here. Along this last line here, and at the same time you make this fold, you're going to pull here this layer like this. Now fold here this cheek behind like this, and you're going to unsync here
this inner layer.
So just one layer, okay? Do not, as you can see here, you have a pack of layers, a lot of layers. You're just going to unsync this middle layer, this one layer. Just keep in mind that layer, we are going to narrow here all these layers to make it look better. But for now, it's okay to have something like this. Now, fold here, one layer to the right. And well, it's ugly here. Well, you should have something like this.
Okay, now fold here these two layers, two points up.
And at the same time, you're going to make this fold here. Now you're going to unsync just one layer, okay? You're going to unwrap your one layer. Be really careful here when you make unsyncs, because you have to fold all the references precisely later, okay? And it's going to look like this. Now you're going to make, okay, we have this line here, right? You have this line here, you're going to unfold, to fold and unfold here, just this first layer, like this, here, exactly like we made before in the other step. Okay. Now you're going to fold this top part. Okay, you're going to sink here, make a sink fold on this top
two layers here. We have this one and this one.
You have to make a sink fold. Okay, let's just make this fold a little bit stronger first. So sink fold these two layers. the model is going to look like this. Okay, now we have one more complicated part, okay? And it's going to be like this. We want to make two more points, one here and one here. So first you have to pull here, both sides like this, and open it a little bit, okay? And after you fold this, you have to make a valley fold straight from this point to this point here. It's going to be like this. Okay? And then, after you make this valley fold, you're going to align here. Both sides, this layer and this layer here, these two layers are going to get aligned. Now you have to pull here a little bit, squash here in the middle. It's going to look like this, and now you just have to fold everything back. Now fold here, this tip down, fold this other layers here to the left, and you're going to repeat all the steps in this side here. So in case you don't remember, let me show you again, but a little bit faster now.
Okay, so if you did all the steps correctly, it should look like this, okay? You have these layers here, these layers here, and the middle flap is going to look like this. So now you have to open here this middle pocket, pull here everything up like this. Now we are going to make something like this. You have these two layers here, right? Push here one layer, the middle layer, to look like this. Okay, and we are going to make a tip. We are going to narrow this point here and this point here, so it's going to be like this. First, you have to reverse here along these two lines. Now, reverse it back along this line here. You're making another zigzag here. Okay? And when you do this, you're going to do the same thing here to the other side. So, open here, make a fold, align it with these corners here, and make another fold back. Like this. So now you have to open it, pull here this flap to the sides, okay, and squash the middle. So we're going to have a square here in front, just like this, okay. Okay, so now we have something like this. So you're going to pull here this flap and open it and okay. Your gum is going to look like this. Okay. Now you have to Now you have to fold here, okay, along this first layer and here at the same time. So it's going to look like this. Now you have to fold here, squashing this top part, okay, and folding this layer to the left, like this. Now do the same thing here. So again, you just have to open here, fold these layers to inside, then fold like this. Now fold here this top layer upward like this, and fold the corners, okay, like this. Now you're going to fold here this corner to the side, just like this, okay. But at the same time you do this, try to make a small reverse fold along the top layer here, just like this. We zoom a little bit more. Okay, so let me show you again. Fold here, fold in half, not in half, fold like this, and make here a small reverse fold on the top layer. If the paper is already too small, you can skip
this reverse fold. It's just a detail anyway.
Okay, now we have to do this fold here, this layer,
like this, and make this layer get locked here between this, the eyes, like this. Now you're just going to hide here this top part, so just fold
behind like this. Okay, now you're going to make
a fold like this, exactly here. The eye part you're going to fold here to inside. Okay, so the same thing here, fold just this inner layer to inside. This.
Okay, now you're going to fold
along this line here, and this last fold here is going to lock everything in this position here.
And finally, we're going to fold everything in half. Okay, the dragon is almost done.
So you just have to add the details now. Like here, you have to do the same thing you did here. I forgot to do it. I think it was step 4 at least. So it's just the same thing. You have to make that sequence of reverse folds.
Okay, now let's make
the head. You have something like this, right? You just have to fold here this layer down like this and fold it forward like this.
Basically, all the dragons have this same detail here.
Okay, now fold the top layer just a little bit like this, and press here a little bit, and as you can see you have a nice eye here. Okay, now this, okay, these layers here you're going to pull it one by one, and fold in half. Okay, so you're just going to make it the horns and these parts here get more thin, get thinner. Okay, well, this one here didn't get nice, because as I was teaching I kind of had to make every step a little bit too fast. But well, it's basically this, you have to keep folding every point here in half. Okay, and the head
is done like this. Continue the body part.
Well, the body will be like this. You have, first of all, you have to fold this layer to inside. Okay, just to hide this layer. And get like this. Now, well, on the tail also, you're going to fold a little bit to inside.
Okay, like this. And well, the tail, it's really easy. You just have to keep making parallel folds here. And it's going to make a nice effect here. Okay, and in the end you just open here these points and the tail and fold in half. Well, basically it's something like this. Okay, let me see here, you must fold the legs also the same way, fold here in half. Okay, fold everything in half and a little bit to the front. In these parts here, it's better to just see the picture of the original origami and keep making the details like this, because this part's more artistic, so you must just keep shaping the origami. Okay, so something like this. Okay, so do this to the front leg also. Okay, just like this, try to open it a little bit. And now the neck, you're going to do the same thing you did to the tail. So try to make this kind of folds, okay, V folds, to give a little bit more effect, more movement to the origami. So it's just like this, keep making parallel folds. And as you can see, it gives more movement to the origami. Well, the wings, you just have to make a fold here. Okay, make a curve here along this line. Then you make parallel folds here. You make a fold like this and a curve here close to the first line. Okay, and it's going to give a nice effect to the wing. Just two folds is okay. And well, the author, the origami creator, Shuki Kato, did fold something like this. He gave more details here, folding everything in half. Well, he gives more details here, he folds it and narrow this point. And gets really similar to the ancient dragon here. Something like this. Okay. So that's it. You just have to make the details on the other side. It's the same way we just made. Okay, so this is the finished origami. Try to see the details here and do the same way. Okay, as you can see, I did fold here the neck several times to make it like this, okay? And the wings. I did make a little bit different from Shuki Kato. But, well, you can just do the way you think it's better. A small curve here. The legs should look like this, okay? Have a small fold downwards, then forward,
And the tail is going to look like this. Just be really careful and try to make all the details. Okay, and well, I really hope you enjoyed this origami here. And thanks for watching this video. So that's it. See you. Bye bye.